Mabuhay! Great day, guys! Welcome to TSA Toy Stash in Action with another toy review. And if you're new to the channel, guys, please do hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up while you're at it. And make sure to hit that notification bell to be updated on every new video we have on the channel. Now, today we're going to be taking a look at the Masters of the Universe Origins Man-at-Arms. So this is actually a very awesome figure. So let's speed things up and get this toy open. Alright, now here it is outside the packaging, rocking that awesome mustache right there, you know, Man at Arms with the entire total of accessories that it comes with. I do believe that you're supposed to have this piece right here, like in one single piece. Done a vintage version. Overall, this is the entire total of you get what you get. Now, taking a closer look for Man at Arms, this is just an awesome figure. You kind of see here, ito actually pinaka improvement niya. That awesome mustache, look at that, sobrang kapal. Yeah. We have here the vintage version yan of Man at Arms. So, you kind of see here for the head sculpt. Yan. You kind of see here na parang mas matandang version yung face sculpt niya dito. Dito parang medyo bata siya. I think it's just because of the, you know, the mustache being right here on this figure. And it's being visible na mas matanda siyang version na to, parang before, diba? Before siya maging ganito. But this is just an awesome taste. You can see it here for the difference. You see the paint here. Yeah, and this is a way darker green, you know, from the vintage. And this is a very light green, yeah. Kind of see the sculpt difference here. Yeah, and going over here. Yeah, and again, this is the difference, the joint right there. And that's how you kind of see it here. Yeah, so the blue here is also darker. Going at the back. And so the other thing here is that, and though, so that's not a difference. What you're seeing here is actually like a broken piece, yan, kasi ito yung sa amin. So I think sa likod parang same lang naman siya. Nothing changed. Oh wait, there is. Okay, so going here for the head, yan. So you kind of see here for the helmet, yung hair dito sa back, it's not painted. Over here it's painted, yan. So that's very awesome. Okay, so here for the helmet, yeah, basic paint then, same paint, same applications there. Okay, so this is actually different. Okay, you do notice that this vintage one has its armor while this, you know, Origins doesn't. So I'm just gonna try to do that camera trick where this thing has the armor, okay? 1, 2, 3, boom, yan. Okay, so nandito na, nakalagay na. Ha ha ha. Okay, edit magic. Thank you, my editor. Yan, so yun siya, yung armor niya. So, and this looks way older and much more right dun sa mga, you know, cartoons version than this one. But this is the vintage one, this is the inspiration out of it. Yan, so pag tinignan mo, basically it's just the same and with the added articulation. Yeah, so ang difference niya dito, guys, is again this armor is, it looks much more bigger. Yeah, so there is, you know, the detail is exactly the same. Yeah, the only difference is eto hatiin na. Yeah, so since it has a joint right here, you can try, you know, you could move it with this figure, and unlike this one, kailangan mo lang talaga isa. And so that's the entire piece right here for Man at Arms, you know, accessories. You got these armor parts. So this is basically like his arms, and so this is on a separate piece, yeah, with the straps. So that's the detail there. You can't see the scope, and so very nice, very nice. And also for, you know, the knee pad right there, kind of see here for the armor piece and the scorpion. You kind of see it. They're a very nice touch. Very similar with the, you know, with the vintage version. Okay, so that's one. And also for his mace. Alright, so this is the Origins mace here, wherein I got here, you know, as I showed earlier again. Yeah, and very very similar lang siya. More improved to noon thing kasi ito medyo hindi siya kita again. And not too special, but the color. But yep, that's the mace. Alright, now for Man-at-Arms articulation, guys. You know, basically it's just the same as the other Origins figure from this figures. Joint, so you got here a bow joint, and so you can spin around 360. This, it can go up, down like that. And also it has a hinge here at the elbows, and so it could go up like this. It's not gonna hinder any articulation, so that's a very nice touch right there. You could put it down and, you know, up, spin it like that. So for the elbows right here, and so single joint hinge right there. It also swivels right there, so that's an awesome thing to do, especially with this you know, armor hand mode that he has. So again, for the wrist, he has a hinge to go up and down, and the swivel part, there you go, so it moves very nicely. Also, he has a swivel here at the waist, and so very smooth. And also for his legs, he could do the splits about this much, and so that's you know, because this is a bow jointed, and you know, for the legs, then up like this, okay, and go down or at the back like that as much. Also here for the knees, he has a single joint, and it's, and also you can actually swivel it and over here. It also has a upper boot cut right here that can swivel, and also a hinge at the feet right there, and ankle pivot. Applying in Man-at-Arms is, you know, a weapon you only get here. You can grab, and so you can do that. And also for his armor pieces, also grab it here for me, and this thing slides in is as is, and so kailangan lang yung kumagat and the slot, there you go, same as the vintage. And also for his arms, yeah, so the lower arm, something new, and can apply it here there, use a little bit of push, yeah. So pag natulak na, yun na siya. So that's how it's gonna look. Okay, and I'm gonna grab this upper piece, put it here on the hinge, and para pwede mo rin apply. Very easy like this. There you go. Okay, yeah, so that's how you apply all his accessories. Alright, now just a quick size comparison for Man-at-Arms. I have here, I'm just gonna put in this Superman from Mattel, you know, one of their basic figures before, and so that you can see the differences from the height to it, and also here for the vintage version of Man-at-Arms. Yeah, and so kind of see na mas matangkad si Man-at-Arms, you know, for the Origins figure. I think this is because of the joint, yeah, and so it could stand better than the vintage version. But overall, you know, you can see here that it can compete with these type of figures, which is the basic from the DC or Marvel things. I don't have any Marvel basics right here, I only have Marvel Legends, but overall, that is, you know, you get the gist out of it. But let's just make it fun. I'm gonna grab here Tila, yeah, and so this is actually from the Origins Tila, yeah, and so if you can see it here, pagkatabi niya, yeah, and so let me try to put it on the stand right there, yeah, basta, And it's just a spot on figure. You can see here, this is a tall, tall figure. It's just very nice and very awesome to get them both like that, you know, in very cool scale. Guys, so that's my take on the figure, and overall it's just an awesome thing. But to add that mustache right there, you know, I'm actually happy with it, the paint apps and everything with the additional mustache here. It's actually sculpted, so that's a very nice feature that they added. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Do share your thoughts on the comment section and hit that thumbs up on the channel, and yeah, subscribe as well. And now remember, guys, life is one big collection. Peace out.